Janet is one of my heroes. The way she approaches this, I have never heard her say, why is this happening to me? I've never heard that. I've seen strong faith. I'm like this when other people, you know, this kind of condition and other conditions, when people could be questioning, why is this happening to me? Why in my life? She doesn't say that. And she'll be in the hospital many times, been in the hospital 3 times in the last 3 months for extended periods of time. I've never heard a complaint. She's weak. She expresses herself like, I just got to go through this. But I just love that fact. And I wish I knew if I would be that strong.
So. She gets it from somewhere.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Not me.
She cares of her heart, and I know just to be normal, not to, again, you know, we take so much for granted that when we have our health. And when you don't have your health, like she said, just taking a walk around the block is a big thing for her. Because, you know, she's got neuropathy in her feet. She's walking on shards of glass when she walks. Do we hope that'll go away? It might ease, but I know it's not going to go away. It's a permanent thing. She's been knocked down so many times.
But she's still in here fighting, right?
She's still in here fighting, absolutely.
Yeah. How is it, like, living every day and not having to worry, like, you know, what is my blood sugar? Or eating something and realizing, what, you know, it's not going to affect you?
Well, I follow the same diet. I didn't really go out. Like, at the hospital, I said, well, what can I eat now? What can I eat? What can I eat? So, well, you can eat anything you want. I said, well, that's probably pretty much the worst diet I've ever been on then, because with the diabetic, I mean, a diabetic diet is a rather healthy diet. A renal diet is not a healthy diet. So, but, you know, I had done it for so long. Some of the things that are hardest for you to deal with right now.
Active for me would be, you know, functioning in my own home, being able to walk from my bedroom to the kitchen without, you know, feeling like I'm going to pass out. I used to love to cook. I can't wait until, you know, I can be back in the kitchen and cooking again. Little things that people might, you know, overlook or take for granted, just taking a daily shower.
How long has it been since you felt like you had a normal life?
It's been years. Every now and then I get little breaks where I'll be able to do some of those functions, but, you know, they don't last long, and then I'm back at the same point that I am. And I just want to be able to, you know, ride a bike, play with my nieces and nephews without, you know, them having to be so careful around me.
Oh, now that you're getting so close to the finish line.
I'm very optimistic. If I wasn't and I let myself not be, then, you know, this is all for nothing. I know it's going to happen. I know that my time is finally going to come, and I look forward to that.
Well, you're sitting here with those people that have received transplants, and I can tell you once it does come, and it's going to be soon for you, it's a wonderful thing, and you'll have a normal life. You know, you're close to seeing that any day, you know.
For me, you know, a miracle is just being like everyone else. That's my miracle. My miracle doesn't go above and beyond. I don't think I'm going to become, you know, Superwoman. But what I am going to become is like everybody else, and that's my miracle.